Everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, JM Lectures. JM stands for Just Mary. That would be me. Today we'll be covering the first unit of grade 9 physics. This unit is vectors. So this unit has three subunits: the representation of vectors, the addition and subtraction of vectors, and some application of vectors. Now to help me explain what a vector is, I'm going to use a movie that I used to watch when I was younger called Despicable Me. This movie has a lot of villains, but one of the villains in this movie is called Vector. Now to explain why his name is Vector, he says this, and I quote, "I commit crime in both direction and magnitude." When I watched this when I was younger, that made no sense to me. But now I realize that he's actually defining what a vector is. He's saying it in crime, but in physics, the definition of vector is a quantity that has both magnitude and direction. But in order to understand vectors a little better, we first have to realize what a scalar is. A scalar is a quantity with only magnitude. When you hear the word magnitude, just think of a value or a number, for instance. But a vector quantity, you have that magnitude, you have that number along with a direction. Let's use examples, which always help understand a concept better. Starting with a scalar quantity, we said a scalar quantity is just a number. So let's say that I'm trying to define how far away my house is. I can say my house is 5 kilometers away. That's a number, it's a quantity, with only magnitude. On top of this magnitude, when we're talking about vectors, if I say my house is 5 kilometers away north, that then becomes a vector quantity. So you have to know scalars in order to understand vectors, but again, the main focus of this grade unit is vectors. Now, in order to represent a vector, you have two methods that you can choose from, either a graphical representation or a symbolic representation. Starting with a graphical representation, it must be probably the most efficient way to describe a vector. What is this method? Using an arrow. Now, why I say this is the most efficient way is because in order to describe a vector, we have to go through those key points, having a magnitude and having a direction. Let's first cover the magnitude part. Now, let's say this vector has an initial and a final point, A and B. The distance between these two points, or the length of the arrow, is how we describe the magnitude of the vector. That means we got one point down, we got the magnitude down. Now for the direction. In order to describe a direction, we can use compass points, we can use north, south, east, west, but that's not always efficient. So we use something we call a reference line. That's the line we have here. So the line we have here is what we call our reference line. Reference line. Why is it called a reference line? Well, honestly, it can be any line, though we usually use the x-axis or a horizontal line. So we see, referencing this line, we see how far away or how elevated the vector is from this reference line. Reference line. So, depending on the angle that this vector makes with this reference line, we can call this angle theta, for example. Depending on that angle, we can then describe the direction. That means that instead of using compass points, we can actually use an angle. Like, let's say, for example, that this theta is 30 degrees. Okay, so this 30 degrees defines the direction, the length from A to B then defines the magnitude. Next, we have symbolic representation. Now, there's two ways to symbolically represent a vector. If you are writing it by hand, you just write the name of the vector, for example, in this case, A, it's usually a capital letter, and you put an arrowhead or an arrow on top of the vector. That's when you're writing it by hand. When you're writing it on your computer, you just write the name of the vector in boldface. So in this case, it's again A, but you write it in boldface. To see the difference between scalar and vectors, let's observe this table we have here. We have a list of vectors, and we can have a list of scalars, and you can see right off the bat that the vectors are all written in boldface, and the scalars are all not written in boldface. I want us to look at the first two examples of both the vectors and the scalars. We see that displacement and distance both have the same symbol S, just as velocity and speed both have the same symbol V. Now, despite the difference of one being bold and one not being bold, it's kind of tricky to figure out the difference between the two. Let's look at displacement and distance. A really good example that I have in order to differentiate the two is the following. Let's say that I'm going on a journey. Let's say that I'm going on a journey and I'm starting at point A. Now, I go through the mountains, across a path, over a bridge, and I come right back to my point A, but let's call my final point a different name, point B. Let's say that I'm given the distance that I traveled. I say S is equal to 10 kilometers. It's a long hike. So, I've traveled 10 kilometers, I traveled a distance of 10 kilometers. Your teacher might ask you, what is my displacement? Well, Both distance and displacement kind of represent the same thing, so you might think, I guess the displacement is also 10 kilometers. But you'd be incorrect, because a key thing about displacement is the quickest way, or the shortest path, or the straightest line to get from point A to point B. This is why it's always helpful to draw out whatever physics question you have. So this question, you see that point A and point B is actually the same point. So initially, the displacement you traveled is nothing at all. If I were to write this down, I would put an arrow on top of the S to represent displacement and say the displacement traveled is 0 kilometers. So these are key differences. Similarly with the velocity and speed, velocity is just how fast you're going but in a certain direction, and speed is just how fast you're going generally. So they might not always be the same. Other examples of vectors are force and acceleration. Other examples of scalars are mass and energy. Now there's a lot of physical quantities. A best way to differentiate whether they're vectors and scalars is give that quantity a direction. And if it doesn't make sense to give it a direction, it's probably a scalar. If it makes sense to give it a direction, it's probably a vector. For example, let's take mass. Let me say that this pen is 10 grams. Does it make sense for me to say this pen is 10 grams west? No, that doesn't make any sense. Which means mass is probably a scalar quantity. It's not a foolproof system, but it helps. Let's describe force. Let's say that I am carrying this pen with a force of 10 newton upwards. I can't even say my sentence without giving it a direction. I'm carrying it. I'm holding it up. Up is my direction, while 10 newton is my magnitude. So that force is definitely a vector quantity. This is the end of the first subunit. Stay tuned for the next subunit on the actual addition and subtraction of vectors.